List of things you didn't know India exported. From precious metals to textiles, from petrochemicals to pharmaceuticals, India has diversified its economy and foreign and trade exchange that substantially contribute to the nation's GDP. India's export is expected to cross $400 billion this year. There are many unusual products that have international demand and India exports to them. Welcome to Braintastic, where today you will know about unusual exports that have quietly been contributing to India's GDP. Human hair. If you have ever been to a salon, they might have tried to persuade in cutting a large chunk of hair. Well, there is a reason why they do that. India grabs the top spot when it comes to human hair export. This massive industry of human hair production exports human hair for more than $400 million. The mesmerizing sight of models hiding their faces in the long shiny hair is a beautiful sight we all witness on TVs. And this business is not only booming in India, but countries like China, USA, Brazil, Italy, Spain, Indonesia, Netherlands, France, and Hong Kong. Being the largest producer, this industry contributes to India's GDP. The hair is largely collected from temples, barber shop, and villages, and is expected to reach $750 million in the year 2020. Amla juice. Indian gooseberry or amla is undeniably a powerhouse of nutrients. From controlling cholesterol, managing diabetes to anti-aging benefits, amla's regular consumption can keep your body healthy and fit. In India, amla is widely used for making pickles, chutneys, jams, and murabba, to even its juice. Did you know that this amazing gooseberry has a great demand internationally? This tangy berry is exported from states like Tamil Nadu, Telangana, and West Bengal to countries like Nepal, Australia, Canada, and the UAE. Seems like foreign grandmothers are also in love with the goodness packed in this little berry. Army shoes. Did you know that an Israeli shoe company chose Make in India long back in 1997? The boots and shoes that most armies stomp into the battle are made in India. The Israeli company Noga Enar Shoes Industry is a leading supplier of professional footwear for military and paramilitary uses in the world. This company has a tie-up with a little-known Kanpur company, Rehman Industries. We all are aware of the brave stories of our soldiers during the Kargil War. But little do people know that the stories of courage and valor that would not have been possible without the contribution of this Kanpur-based company, which is now one of the biggest arms exporters in India. They serve armies, police forces, special forces, anti-riot and anti-terror units worldwide. The military and paramilitary forces around the world walk in confidence while protecting their nation from the boots made in Kanpur. Dried moss. Do you remember playing around ponds or lakes as a kid? If yes, you might have been yelled by your parents for staining your clothes from grass and moss. But do you know moss is so important that it is exported from India to countries like the USA, Canada, Japan, Netherlands, Croatia, etc. Moss is used for decorative purposes around the world. India bags the 7th spot to become the largest country in terms of land area and greenery. Kolkata is the leading producer and exporter of moss in India. The moss plant is mainly found around lakes and rivers and is a very profitable product. Jellyfish. Jellyfish are gelatinous swimmers that have been around for more than 500 million years. They do not have brains and bones, but this multi-organism creature can give a lethal sting. These ancient creatures are more than just stinging. In fact, their incredible versatility may surprise you. They are also a popular food in Southeast Asia countries. from desserts such as ice creams to salads and even noodles, jellyfish are consumed in various edible forms. It is a delicacy in Japan, China, Vietnam, and Korea. India is amongst the major exporters of jellyfish in the world, where Simandhra and Tamil Nadu are the leading producers. Here's a trivia for you guys. It is a common myth that if a person is stung by a jellyfish, then another person can urinate on the sting to relieve the pain. But in reality, you should remove tentacles carefully with tweezers to get rid of the pain. Get more such trivia on our Instagram and Facebook handles. The link is given in the description box below. Body armor. What do you recall when words like battle and soldiers strike your mind? Well, armors and bulletproof jackets, of course. Armory and ammunition are a thriving business today, and India is a leading provider to many countries. States like Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Punjab, and Haryana are home to prominent companies that manufacture and export full body armor. They typically export to countries like the USA, Canada, and Sweden, where it is majorly involved in entertainment purposes and display in exhibitions and plays. Who doesn't remember the world's most popular films and TV shows, including Assassin's Creed,
The Spanish Inquisition,
and Game of Thrones? Turns out that a Dehradun-based company, Lord of Battles, made the popular armors and handicraft products for the popular show GOT. They make in India, but sell weapons, armors, accessories, etc. abroad. Metro coaches. Transport infrastructure is one of the most important factors for a country's progress. And people living in big cities can't even imagine their lives without the metro trains. India is among the 55 countries that have a metro rail network. However, its share in the global rail network is currently limited to only 3%. Make in India initiative is reaching worldwide and filling the hearts of people with patriotic pride. Australia and Brazil have given a consignment of metro coaches. This event has made history since this was the first time that India exported metro coaches. The coaches are 75 feet long and weigh 46 tons each. India will export a total of 450 metro coaches to Australia and 521 bogie frames for Brazil's Sao Paulo monorail in over a 2.5 year period. Garbage. The last thing in our list that India exports is the waste material dumped from our home. Yes, you heard it right. India exports garbage to countries in order to produce sustainable energy. Since the Industrial Revolution, waste has been a major environmental issue worldwide. India alone generates more than 1 lakh metric tons of solid waste every day. We know the harmful effect of our throwaway culture, and generating power through waste has emerged as one of the most convenient energy sources of the 21st century. Waste to energy, or energy from waste, is a green initiative that generates energy in the form of electricity or heat from waste. It is a form of energy recovery that is executed by many countries to make a sustainable environment. India, being the third largest producer of garbage and the fifth largest producer of e-waste, exports garbage to those countries who suffer a shortage of waste. China imports e-waste, followed by the United States and European countries. So that was the list, guys. Give a big thumbs up if you liked the video, and don't forget to share this with your family and friends. Thank you. Friends, we are excited to announce the launch of our digital library, where our viewers can buy informative ebooks. We will keep adding new editions across all categories. The link is in the description. Also, guys, don't forget to subscribe to Braintastic and press the bell icon.